Ankit Kumar. Acharya ji, pranam. People's faces and vocal tonality shows what they mean in actuality. But people like to have control of their emotions, like an actor. They dumb down our intellect using emotions. How to recognize such people and their intention? They make my logic feel so low with their wordplay that sometimes even I start doubting my logic. I may be able to counter them sitting at home, but in social situations it gets much more difficult. In groups, they will turn everyone against me if I speak against them. They are not saints, so there have to be some fundamental mistakes or defects in their ways. Ankit Kumar. Ankit, it surprises me how most of you are unable to see through to his mischiefs and all the adulterations in his sentences. In fact, it would be a good exercise. Pick up anything from Tuhi and you should be able to clearly underscore those parts of his speech where he has played the trick, where he has performed that sleight of hand. Your inability to call him out or spot the exact trick is coming from your lack of familiarity with the scriptures. What Tuhi is using is scriptural language to justify his petty ends. But if you are conversant really with the scriptures, then you will see where he is deviating from the scriptures. It's very easy to figure out. You'll be able to pinpoint the exact words and that those little sentences where he plays his deft trick. You said, no, he was going all right, and now here. Here he has pulled a fast one. Like magicians do on stage. They keep demonstrating everything to you as if their entire procedure is quite transparent. So this is the table, this is the box, and now I'm putting the girl in the box, and you say, yes, the girl is there. In fact, they'll call somebody from the crowd to verify. See, this is a real girl, touch her, hold her, yes, she's real. This is a real box, yes, real box. This is a real axe. Now the girl goes into the box, and then the magician chops off the box with the axe. And you're saying, oh my God, the girl is gone. And then the next moment, the girl reappears along with four rabbits. And you are like, wow, how did it happen? Huh? You must read the book of sorcery. That's the way to beat the magician. Read his book. Just as I said yesterday that we do not know much about Rourke's past. But he surely had some training in spirituality. Similarly, Ayn Rand has very neatly hidden the fact that Tuhi too must have had some training in scriptures. Must have gone to some teacher, stayed there for a while, then run away or kicked out. Such people are called as yog bhrasht. So they learn something from the teacher, but not the real thing. But they manage to learn just about enough to hoodwink the commoners. Then they can talk very, very convincingly. Because at least they have learnt the words. Now they can go out and fool the commoners. Mutassim has not asked anything today. Mutassim Tuhi managed to hoodwink you because Tuhi has gone deeper into scriptures than you have. See, scriptures are helping even Tuhi. If you want to beat Tuhi, go into the scriptures deeper than Tuhi has. Just as one is to write the making of Howard Roark, if one were to compose the making of Ellsworth Tuhi, it would definitely include a shady Tuhi running away in the dead of the night from the teacher's place or being kicked out. Such people become very dangerous because they know something, and that makes them convincing to the outsiders. They will say, I know the inside story, I have been there. I'll tell you the real thing, I know. I was with the teacher for 5 years. Or sometimes they may say, no, I was never with the teacher. It's all my own download from the skies. It's all original. Tuhi anyway does not believe in any teacher-like authority. He only believes in mass commonality. If you'll ask him, he'll say, oh, all men are products of their times and places. Nobody is special. Let nobody try to act awakened or unique. There's nothing called individuality. The man who speaks in scriptural parlance, the moment you come across him, be very alert. He would either be of great benefit to you, or he poses a great danger to you. If he is real, then he will enable your liberation. But if he is not real, then he will himself become your greatest bondage. So, if you want to see through Tuhi, go deeper into the scriptures. That's the only way. If you want to see through your inner Tuhi, go deeper into the scriptures. That's the only way. Otherwise, you will keep getting ruled by your inner Tuhi.